Change can be confusing. This is true for relationships, governments, and even to a degree the weather, pun intended. This is especially true for software changes on your devices and equipment. Whose brain hasn't exploded at least once while you're messing around with your settings after an update? In 2019, Blackmagic changed from their Cinema DNG codec format to their self-branded codec, Blackmagic RAW, which wowed many but perplexed others. Today, we're going to do a quick review of what Blackmagic RAW is and go over what the different encoding options are, look at some of the settings, and check out the quality. So if you're still struggling to figure out the current codec, or if you're new to the Blackmagic game, pay close attention because today is going to have a ton of helpful information. As always, make sure to subscribe below and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all of our content. So, what even is Blackmagic RAW and what does it do? Blackmagic RAW is a codec that is found on the Pocket 4K and other Blackmagic devices. For those of you who don't know this already, the definition of codec is a device or computer program which encodes or decodes a digital data stream or signal. Codecs are generally used for streaming media, video editing, and video conferencing. Blackmagic RAW has two separate encoding settings, constant bitrate and constant quality. Each of these settings has a multitude of options to choose from. So let's start with constant bitrate first, which gives you predictable file sizes and high quality images. With constant bitrate, you get four ratio options to choose from. So let's say, for example, if you have an uncompressed file that is 548 megabytes and choosing the ratio of 5:1 will compress your file down to 110 megabytes per second. If you are someone that has limited space available on your drives but has a lot to shoot, the constant bitrate options are pretty fantastic. An important thing to keep in mind here is that these options can mess with some of the quality of the footage you are shooting. The most likely images to be affected are those that are in motion and have a high number of interconnecting items. So if you're planning on filming confetti, snow, leaves, or really anything that moves in a similar way, be sure to keep this information in mind. Now it's time to take a look at constant quality. This setting only comes with two options, Q0 and Q5. Constant quality is different from constant bitrate because with this, you get to have fluctuating bitrate and do not need to worry about an upper data limit. Essentially, this means that the aforementioned confetti, snow, and leaves will show up a lot clearer than with constant bitrate. The drawback is that these files fluctuate in size and are going to be much larger and way more unpredictable in size due to the varying bitrate. So purchase your drives wisely if this is the route that you want to go. So what's the difference between the options of Q0 and Q5? This one really isn't as complicated as the constant bitrate options, but it's really as simple as Q0 has minimum quantization and gives the highest possible quality, while Q5 plays it safe with more efficient encoding and a smaller file size. When it comes down to it, the changes in quality between all these options are pretty minimal. It's not like we're talking about taking a 4K video and dropping it down to VHS quality to save on space. A standard person on the street that's not used to dealing with any sort of videography probably wouldn't even know the difference. But to us, the differences can still be important. But what setting options are the best for you? Well, it really depends on what you plan on filming. In a lot of cases, users of the BMPCC4K will end up using a combination of settings for the entire project they're working on. That best suits the information that you're having to film with that specific scene. I actually found a really good explanation of this in an old Reddit thread, of all places. Basically, it gives the example of shooting a blank piece of paper versus shooting a person in a room with the windows drawn. The piece of blank white paper is going to have very little information to record, being that it's a static item with one color. Since the bitrate on the paper will already be pretty low, it's safe to assume that the constant bitrate setting would be best for this. Now, if you're looking to shoot something along the lines of the second example, the person in the room with the windows drawn, constant quality will probably be the best way to go about it depending on what you're filming. The person in the shot, regardless of whether they are stationary or in motion, by nature is going to have a lot more information to capture than the piece of paper. Adding in the person's surroundings and assuming that there are items in motion through those drawn windows like snow or rain, that's going to make that bitrate shoot up a lot. Typically, in my experience, I've found constant quality perfect for unpredictable situations like filming underwater. There is a ton going on when you film underwater and you want all the bitrate you can to deal with all the details. I've also found filming at a higher bitrate or in constant quality to be useful for poorly lit environments and helps to either ease some of the noise in the footage or to help with noise reduction in post. But for those things like this video, I'm shooting at a 12:1 constant bitrate, and it looks fine. I mean, YouTube already compresses, and I would really only recommend jacking up your bitrate for important shoots or things, you know, that you're not going to be able to film again. For YouTube content and me talking directly to camera, 12:1 ratio works just fine, and it keeps me from having to expand my already bad storage situation. That's another story. Feel like I missed something or said something wrong? Please let me know in the comments below so we can correct it. Thanks for watching today's episode, and be sure to subscribe to our channel below and hit the notification bell to keep up to date with all of our latest videos. Until next time, this is John Owens with Frame Voyager.